Yo, what is going on, guys? And in today's video, I'm going to be teaching you guys on how to upload any photo as your crew emblem on GTA 5. So let's get started. So the first thing you guys want to do is go on gtapixels.com, make an account. Once you guys do that, go over to gallery, click on it. Once you guys click on gallery, you want to click on create your own emblem. So once you guys click on it, you guys want to click choose a file and upload any photo you guys want. I'm using the baby for an example. So I'm just going to, you know, title it whatever you want. I'm just going to put the baby, put any settings you guys want. I'm putting it on private, and make sure you guys click that check mark. Submit the emblem. For me, I kept it private, so I'm going to keep it private. So right now it's loading. Also, I want to mention that you guys need to use Google Chrome for that. You guys cannot use Firefox or Internet Explorer, whatever you guys use. All right, so right now it's loading. It's generating the emblem. So once it's done, you guys are going to wait for about 3 to 5 minutes for it to cool down. Now, if you guys go right now, do the whole process, inspect, paste, you guys, well, most of you guys know that process. It's not going to work, at least for me. So I always wait 3 to 5 minutes in this screen just for it to load completely. But you guys don't have to do that, but I do it. So I'm just going to wait for a couple minutes and I'll be back. All right, guys, we're back. So the next step is to click on the blue button under the emblem. Once you guys do that, you guys want to go ahead and open the file. I'm using RimWire to open it up, but you guys can use any application to open up a file. All you really need is the console.txt. Open it up, copy everything that's inside of it, and close it up. And you guys want to head over to Rockstar Emblem Editor, right-click, inspect. And once it opens up, you guys want to head over to console and paste the code you just copied, and then press enter. Now, this method's already patched, so it's going to give me some sort of error. But don't worry, guys, I already found a new method. Well, someone in my other video found one. All right, so you guys head over to the description below and copy this whole code that's in the description. And once you guys copy it, you guys want to scroll up and find where it says var request, I think it says. So I'm going to zoom in for you guys so you guys can see. But basically, you guys want to highlight the whole thing all the way to the bottom where the semicolon is. So yeah, so once you guys have the whole thing highlighted, sorry, you guys want to go ahead and control V or paste. And once you do that, you guys want to press enter, and it should work. So right here, I'm going to show you guys proof that it does work. So there you go, guys. So it's that simple. It's not that hard. Maybe a little one extra step from the last video if you guys came from that video. So yeah, guys, it's that simple. I hope you guys do enjoy the video. If you guys have any questions, feel free to ask, to leave a comment. Sorry. Feel free to leave a comment and I'll try to respond as soon as possible. I know I have been uploading. It's already been almost a year since my last video. So yeah, it's crazy. So I'm gonna try to start uploading again, and maybe you guys should give me ideas. What should I post next? So yeah, guys, peace. Let's go.